Yo, how you doing? How's it going? Back in black with some more enlisted news. Today they extended the current battle pass by 2 days just so they had enough time to make a bunch of current revisions and upgrades to the next battle pass, which will be coming out in a couple of days. If you guys are new to the channel and you enjoy shooting games, make sure you guys aim for that like button and shoot that subscribe button as well. It really helps me out as a small YouTuber, and it'll make sure the teammates that you get actually play the objective. Let's go ahead and get into the news really quick. Like I said before, we have an extra 2 days with the current battle pass, which basically means that the new battle pass will start on June 24th. It's very convenient for me because I actually was one battle pass level away from getting my second gold weapon order, so I was actually kind of happy about that, but that's neither here nor there. As far as the new and improved rewards and upgrades, they say it's a lot more varied. As far as which we will be getting, that will include orders for soldier level increases, orders for weapon upgrades, grades, orders to change your soldier call sign, and unique posters for your battle pass. They weren't necessarily super detailed with the additions that were being implemented right here, so I guess I will take the time to go a little bit more in depth because I was talking to some of the community members on Reddit and they enlightened me to a couple of them. So as far as orders for the soldier level increase, that's basically like as you make your way throughout the battle pass, you will receive orders that will literally let you upgrade your soldiers to another level. So like let's say you have a 1-star and you get an order for an upgrade, you'll be able to move them up to 2-star, or you might even be able to move them all the way up to 3, 4, or 5-star, or even just get a 5-star soldier outright, if I'm not mistaken. The same concept applies to the weapon upgrade. So move up through the battle pass a little bit more, you can get orders that will upgrade your weapon to level 2, which is actually super nice, because as far as like upgrading the weapons and breaking down, disassembling old guns for all those parts, it was very much so a chore that I personally did not care to participate in, and I'm sure a lot of you guys don't do that as well. And I guess they're trying to find a way to make that upgrade system more like streamlined and appeal more to the casual player base, because I play this game a lot and I don't even do it. So I know somebody who casually plays this game would never think like, oh, let me go upgrade my guns, or let me go to the academy and trade in my soldiers for another upgrade or something like that. Fun fact though, trading in all your 1-star troopers and engineers to upgrade them to like 2 stars and 3 stars is actually a very, very useful thing to do, especially if you have like the premium squad. It only takes like a couple of minutes and you will reap the benefits of having soldiers that have more perks. But that's neither here nor there. Moving on to the third bullet point, as far as like the order to change your soldier's call sign, I believe that is just the ability to change the name of your soldier, which is like a, I would consider that a small quality of life improvement. But if you just see a name that you don't like and you want to change it, you will have the ability to do that now. And they also, like I said, unique posters for the soldiers and the battle pass. That's more like things that you can like spray on the wall or like spray on the floor or something like that, if I'm not mistaken. Or what else would you use posters? Were they gonna have like propaganda in the game or something like that? I mean, it actually sounds kind of cool. I mean, the more like cosmetic and artsy stuff they add, like camos and stuff, like the better. I'm not mad at it at all. Moving on, they will also be adding new and unique weapons to the Battle Pass as well. The first one is the PDM-42, which is an experimental SMG developed by Degtyarev. It's Russian, by the way. I know I kind of butchered that name. The PDM-42 is chambered in 7.62 mm caliber, which is a very strong bullet, and was considered as a replacement for the PPSH, but lost to Sudev's PPS-42. It will be available for the Red Army in the Battle of Moscow and Battle of Berlin campaigns. Hey, two campaigns, you'll love to see it. Moving on, we got the M2A1 carbine. This is a fully automatic modification of the M1A1 carbine produced by the US Marines. Oh, we're gonna see that in the Pacific campaign, because where else do you see Marines at? Why else would they mention Marines? You love to see it. That is another further confirmation. Well, they already confirmed it, but further confirmation always makes me feel good. Let's see. This is an ancestor of the personal defense weapon. Oh, I didn't even know that. So PDW, small handheld, like compact guns. The M1 carbine is the predecessor to that. This example will be available to the U.S. Army in the Invasion of Normandy campaign, obviously. Moving on, the next gun is the KP-26. This is a Finnish SMG developed by Amio Lahti. It was the prototype for the entire Suomi SMG line. If you guys play Battlefield 5, you will know that the Suomi SMG was top tier as far as SMG goes. The only other thing I could think of that was comparable in Battlefield 5 was the Tommy gun, which I would love to comment on how the Tommy gun feels in this game, but it's such a high unlock and it takes so long to unlock stuff that I'm going to have to get back to you guys on that one. Moving on to the next gun, we have the Guerrier 43. Chambered in 7.9 millimeter curves. This is an experimental rifle based on obviously the Guerrier 43, and has a 30 round magazine. It will be available for the Germans in the Normandy campaign and the Battle of Berlin campaign. And obviously the standout feature with this gun is that 30 round magazine. If you already thought the Guerrier was good, imagine one with a 30 round magazine. It's obviously exponentially better. I have nothing bad to say about that. They will also be adding new and unique soldiers, and they are all rank 5. They say in the Battle Pass season, you will get 6 unique soldiers, yada, yada, yada. The first one is Pavel Golichikov, and he is a Red Army sniper. He will be in the Battle of Moscow. The second one is Gerbert Heinz, Heinz Ketchup. He is a German sniper, also in the Battle of Moscow. The next guy is going to be Denis Dotsenko. He is a 5-star bomber for the Battle of Berlin, Russian Army. And the next guy is Ermin Reim, also a bomber for the Battle of Berlin. I mean, the main takeaway you need to know about these 5-star soldiers is that just the simple fact that they are rank 5, all that means is that they're going to have an absurd amount of perks. And usually the perks that they're going to get to choose from are going to be on the higher, like, S-tier perks. On the side of high-tier S-tier perks. Oh my god, I butchered that. That is horrible. Not only will we be getting 5-star soldiers with the new Battle Pass, we will also be getting 5 new tanks and 1 new aircraft, which is so lovely. Like, I just want to take a step to, clap it up for the enlisted developers, because before, the Battle Pass to me was kind of like a waste of time. Like, why would anybody in their mother's mindset want to buy the Elite Battle Pass? But for the simple fact that they are adding, like, vehicles, soldiers, and weapons to it, it adds so much exponential value. So I really do appreciate that they took the time out to do that. But getting back on track, they will be adding new vehicles. The first one is the T-50 tank for the Battle of Moscow. The next one is the BF-110 for the Battle of Moscow, which is a very good bomber, by the way, if you guys don't know. Not bomber, like a plane in general. You know what I mean. The next one is a M8 tank for the invasion of Normandy. They don't even have pictures for these. I'm kind of sad. I should probably Google some and insert them. The next one is the T-34-85 for the Battle of Berlin. And then the next one is the Panther G for the Battle of Berlin, which I thought you could already unlock that or buy that, but I could be mistaken. The neat thing about these vehicles is that they say that all of these will feature unique camouflages, and some will have technical modifications that are delivered to you fully upgraded. So when you do unlock these weapons in the Battle Pass, you don't even got to upgrade them. They will already come maxed out, and you love to see it. As far as for the unique weapons and soldiers of the current season of the Battle Pass, they will be available for purchase with golden orders and enlisted gold during the next season, so you won't miss your opportunity to unlock any of those. But yeah, other than that, that is pretty much it for all the news. Let me know what you guys think about that down in the comments. Are you enjoying the changes that they are going to make to the Battle Pass? Are you happy that they extended the current one for a couple of days if any of you are missing out on any of those gold orders? Other than that, thank you guys so much for watching the video. I will see you guys on the battlefield. And make sure you guys check me out on Twitch at Black Guy YouTube. See you in the next video. Black Guy out.